Hi. It's hard to say when we're talking about, a critical position like a CEO or a manager or the head of a large department or even a small department, or even when we talk about leadership in general, that doesn't have to be exercised from a formal authority position, I mean from any position. In general, it's hard to say which decisions are most critical, because any decision at its own time is most critical. You see what I'm saying? When it's time to make a decision that will have certain implications, at that moment, every decision is important, because if you get that decision wrong, then it will not become good. There will be consequences. So every decision has to be properly thought of. That's in general, you see? But I can safely talk about two major decisions that are of significant importance. The first one is your decision or the way you design the strategy. Because at core, strategy is about the choices that you make on how you allocate your limited resources. If you have hundreds of thousands, tens of thousands of dollars, let's say millions or even billions, it doesn't matter. Whatever resources you have, in general, they are limited. And even if they're not limited, when we're talking about strategy, we're talking about major decisions. So, major allocation of resources, of money, of time, of the focus of the organization for the next 3 to 5 years, of people's priorities, of the organizational priorities. All of that is an implication of the design of your strategy. So, perhaps the most sort of important and challenging and critical decision a CEO or a department manager or a boss, or even when you're exercising leadership, that a person can take is your decisions on the strategy, i.e., how do you mobilize and allocate the resources of your organization for the next 3 to 5 years? Because if you get that wrong, if your strategy is not properly designed, then all of these resources will be wasted. Many opportunities in the future will be wasted. The cost of doing a U-turn, coming back and doing sort of a course adjustment will be expensive if you can afford it. And there will be extensive damage to the morale, to your brand, your reputation, because your choices were wrong and you sort of took the wrong exit. And had to go so far before you make a U-turn. So imagine where your competition will be at that time. That's why the first thing that comes to mind is making sure that the strategy that has been designed by you as the head of the company, organization, department, country is a sound one. And that's, in the end, is your responsibility. The second critical decision that I think of as, of strategic importance is, of course, the choice of people. I mean, everything else that, when you borrow money, invest money, the way you invest in technology, what technology you choose, all of these are important. But if I have to choose, after strategy, I talk about people. Because, in the end, whatever you have, money, strategy, assets, in the end, who's going to manage this? Who's going to execute the strategy? Who's going to use, the machines, operate the factories, look after clients, create products and services? It's people. And once you get, when you get people, number one, it's expensive in terms of time and effort to get people. So it would take months to hire people. And you have to go through a process. And once they're in, it would also take them months until they get used to the job and to the culture and to your thinking and the strategy and the way the organization operates. And if the choice was wrong, the implications of this bad choice will be on the execution of the strategy, on the job itself, on the morale, on the mood, on the quality of, standards that are applied in the work. I mean, you name it, because everything they do will be compromised. So the entire operation will suffer, and changing them also will be expensive, because you will have to go through the whole process of, letting them go emotionally, financially, practically, maybe even legally, and then you have to, you know, start looking for replacement. That will take another several weeks, if not months, and then through the whole process of reorientation again, and, you know, getting it right. So when you hire people, pay attention that you get the best people possible, and don't save any, don't do shortcuts. If you can, you know, get 5 people to interview them, let them do so. If you can get them to do a number of these personality sort of exercises that elaborate on their personalities, do that. Any kind of examination of, you know, thorough thinking and process that you do when you hire people is worth it. Because the cost of, you know, fixing a mistake like this is expensive. So these 2 things, strategy, get your strategy right and get your people right, and I think, you know, 90% you're done.